My name is John Ramsay. I am a graduate student, a PhD candidate in the Biomes program, and I look at how muscles change in size after someone has had a stroke, and I try to use that information to create computer simulations of how they move after they've had a stroke. Mainly I work alone. Most of my work is on a computer, but we obviously work with a cohort of fellow students in the lab, and we're all kind of trying to ask and answer the same questions. So probably at least once a week I'm working with multiple people.
Let's take a step back and talk about what influenced you to enter into this specific field. Did you always want to be a medical researcher, or did you kind of have a different career path when you were in high school or even in early college?
I did not always want to be in this field. Actually, I didn't know this field existed. My father was an engineer, my mom was a therapist, and so I kind of wanted to do something that might have followed what they were doing, and just happened to see an article that kind of it showed biomedical engineering and kind of the combination between therapy and engineering, and that got me hooked. In my undergrad, when you entered into the engineering program, you kind of followed the track that you were on, and so I had started with a biomedical engineering track, and my professor just the first day was like, if you ever want to get involved in the lab, come down and see what we got. And I went down, saw what some of the older students were doing, and got involved that way, and ever since I've just enjoyed what I've been doing. Engineering is difficult. You have to answer problems that are sometimes abstract and that there might not even be an answer to. And so it requires you to problem solve, and sometimes you have to think outside the box, and if you're not good at that or if you haven't really been open to that, then it can become challenging sometimes. So on a day-to-day basis, I will come in, and if we have a lab meeting, I'll meet with my other lab mates. We'll talk about kind of the progress we've made, if we have any problems. And then I get into my work, and that's mainly some form of computer coding or tracing muscles from an MRI. I was born in Johnson City, New York. It's upstate New York. Home to me was, we lived on a hill with lots of acreage of woods, and being able to run around with my brother and just kind of explore and get dirty. I think we're at the point where technology can help us answer a lot of questions that we wouldn't have been able to answer before, and now we're starting to answer or ask those questions. And I think you give this field 10, 15 years, and we're going to be able to use computer simulations to predict the outcome of different therapies. We're going to be able to possibly look at different medical images and be able to determine what type of therapy would be best suit that person without even having them come into to come into a research lab. I think there's a lot of growth in the technology and in the medical use of the science. Success is making a difference. It's and if when you see people come in through the lab or through the clinic, each person has their own disability, and if you can help one person, if your entire career just helps one person, to me that's a success. Just think outside the box. Think about what you're learning and how it can apply to not just your field, if there's questions you just don't know the answer to, don't be afraid to try to investigate why. You might not get the answer right away. But that's part of the fun, is trying to figure it out and trying to solve the problems. And they could be little things. But if you're asking the questions, and trying to find the answers, then I think that's going to help you in this field.
you.